10 football from Lincoln, a Legends Division battle. Here come the Cornhuskers. Everyone to Big Ten Network Football, a sunny but windy November afternoon. It's a battle of NU's, Northwestern, and the Nebraska Cornhuskers. Nebraska currently 10th in the BCS standings. So glad you could join us, everybody, here in Lincoln, Nebraska, with my partner Chris Martin. I am Eric Collins. These two teams last met here in Lincoln back in 1974. This time around, Northwestern comes in with a hot offense. They set all kinds of records a week ago against Indiana.
And for Northwestern, the conversation always starts with Dan Persa. He's the trigger man for their offense. And really, he's most dangerous when he freelances, gets outside of the pocket to find Kane Coulter, their best pure athlete. Also something to look for, Eric, against this Nebraska defense. They play a lot of cover too. Jeremy Ebert, Drake Dunsmore must work the middle of the field. That's the attack point.
Well, Nebraska coming off a really nice win a week ago against Michigan State. We saw them ride their stud, Rex Burkhardt, a lot of times, 35 carries and probably 35 bruises.
Yeah, Burkhead's their stud guy, and they want to give him the ball. There's no trade secrets here. They're going to try to run the ball down Northwestern's throat. This is a guy, he's a north-south runner. He wants to run you over, get back up, run you over again, and until you hit submission.
All right, on a windy afternoon, we are ready to put the ball in the air. Nebraska's going to start on offense. Northwestern won the toss. They deferred until the second half. Looking up into a sunny sky, this is Tim Marlow on the return. And Marlow, the junior out of Youngstown, Ohio, gets it to the 30-yard line. Let's go to Deion Miller, standing by fieldside.
Well, Eric, hang on to your hats for this one. The high winds that are affecting all of the Midwest have arrived in Nebraska. Gusts upwards of 30 miles an hour, could be 40 before the end of the game. Our anemometer is consistently getting a reading of about 20 miles an hour. Cannot help but affect this game. You cannot ignore it. It'll be which team is able to play with it that could be the difference, Eric.
Thank you, Deion. Now, Nebraska, they like to keep the ball on the ground. Maybe the wind won't be as much of a factor as it is for Northwestern. First down carry there by Rex Burkhead. Let's take a look at our K Jewelers keys to victory. Chris.
Well, it has to be to make Taylor Martinez a thrower. As Deion pointed out, there's a swirling wind. Make him have to throw. For Nebraska, though, it's physicality. They have to pull the car to Northwestern. Let the cats show they can be physical.
Short gain on first down, second and seven. Trying to get to the edge this time. Amir Abdullah is tackled from behind. It's going to bring up a third down and long for the Huskers. Now Taylor Martinez, now in his second season as the starter for Nebraska. These are his season-long numbers.
Well, Eric, I think the key here is that Northwestern's going to stack the box. They have to commit to stopping the run, make Martinez put it in the air, particularly with how windy it is.
Nebraska averaging 252 yards per game on the ground, second only to Michigan. Martinez, his first throw, shoots it out. Burkhead makes the first man miss, and he's going to have enough for a Cornhusker first down.
That's the part of the game of Burkhead that often gets overlooked. He's a downhill north-south runner, but he can be active outside.
Let's take a look at the offensive line for Nebraska. Hardrick Rodriguez on the left side. Mike Caputo playing great football as the center. Head coach Bo Pelini says he makes zero mistakes. And now the first mistake of the game for either side. We've got movement.
False start. Offense. Number 81. 5-yard penalty. The down remains. Third.
Now it's Dave Whitvogt, today's referee, and he calls that penalty against Nebraska. They're going to call it on Ben Cotton, the tight end. Got a little bit antsy. And it'll be a first down and 15. Burkhead out of the game. Eye back, Amir Abdullah. Martinez to throw it again, flips it out. Is it caught? They're going to say it is. Brandon Kinney with the catch.
When you look at Taylor Martinez from a week ago, Eric, he didn't complete any passes in the first half against Michigan State. Interesting to see him coming out firing. That time completing it to McKinney.
Ball was low and Kinney got his fingers under the ball. So second down now. Option, Martinez nowhere to go. Good defense played by Quentin Williams and others for Northwestern. Take a look at the Northwestern backs and receivers. Rex Burkhead, you wonder how he's going to bounce back from last week when he carried the ball 35 times. Marlowe, Bell, and Kinney are your receivers with Tyler Legate, the fullback. Burkhead, the eye back, as the entire offense looks to the sideline. Third down at 6. Over the middle, it's caught again. Burkhead, and this time the tackle's made short of the first down marker. Chichi Araguza, who they really like at Northwestern, stops him in the open field.
Oh, and that's a good stand for the Cats on money down, able to get off the field. Look at Burkhead sort of limping a little bit.
So Northwestern gives up a first down and then eventually stops Nebraska and forces the punt team to come on. Red Maher also doubles as the place kicker, punted away. Hendrick Mark back deep. Little rugby style kick. This kick is into the wind. Nebraska's gonna get a great roll. Ball's gonna go out of bounds at the 10-yard line. So instead of kicking it up high into the wind, it's a low runner and it works out just fine for Nebraska.
Look at that wind just gusting through the stadium. Things to watch the pass game. Dan Persa is extremely accurate when he's on the move and throwing when he starts to freelance. But he's got to challenge not only the defense of Nebraska, this gusting wind.
Look at the numbers so far this season. He completes 75% of his passes. Last year, he had similar numbers, completing 73% of his passes, setting a new Big Ten record. On first down, Jacob Schmidt gets the carry. He's tackled by Lamonte David. Let's take a look at Northwestern's offensive line. Netter and Burkett have a bunch of starts combined, but the redshirt freshman at center, Brandon Vitabile, he is a guy who has been a real surprise for the Wildcats offensively. He has been solid in his first year as a starter. Over the middle, they're going to get it to King Coulter, and Coulter, their difference maker, gets a big chunk of yards all the way across the 40-yard line.
Well, we talked about this in the open. Folks at home, you're going to see a cover two shell from Nebraska. What that means is they get their safety very deep to take away the outside throw. So where's the hole or the cavity? It's the middle of the field. Expect to see a lot of these throws today.
Actually marked the ball on the 36, and this time another pass completed over the middle, but not much of a gain. Demetrius Fields with the catch. Now it's Drake Dunsmore. Dunsmore a week ago with 4 touchdown catches against Indiana. As we take a look at the Northwestern backs and receivers, there is Dunsmore as the super back, as they call him. Jacob Schmidt also had a day a week ago against Indiana, rushing for 110 yards. Dunsmore, the man in motion. Handoff, first run of the game. Trayvon Green barrels out across the 45, tackled by Lamonte David. And that'll bring up a third down. As we take a look at the Auto Owners Insurance defense for Nebraska, Cameron Meredith plays the run really well. He's also the best pass rusher on the team with 4 sacks. Lamonte David, what a special player he is. He can cover wide receivers. He's a linebacker, folks. Had 13 sacks a week ago against Michigan State, and they're going to be in the nickel quite often against this Northwestern offense. Alfonso Dennard, maybe the best cornerback in all of college football. Trayvon Green runs it on 3rd and 1 and picks up the first down for Northwestern.
Yeah, you pointed it out, Eric. When you look at this Nebraska defense, Lavonte David is the best linebacker in college football. He can do it all in terms of take on. He's a guy that can flow and get to the football. And as you noted, he does well in coverage. He can cover the Northwestern wide receiver.
Persa again hands it off to Green. And this time Green is stopped. didn't even get back to the line of scrimmage. There's that man, number four, Lavonte David, combining with Terrence Moore on the stop.
Well, the key is when you play against this defense is you have to attack them in the middle, right between the tackles, sort of the teeth of that defense. But good job stretching it out and getting to the ball.
Quick snap for Northwestern, completed. First catch, Jeremy Ebert, and Ebert has first down yards.
Ebert is their big play threat. He's a guy that has precise route running. He knows where to stick it on defensive backs, and he always finds the chains. He's the target man for Dan Persa.
All right, not a surprise here. We're going to see a lot of this. Dan Persa leaves the game, and we're going to have Kane Coulter calling the signals. He hands it off first man through Venrick Mark. He's been getting more and more playing time as a running back. Began the season as a wide receiver. Mark's first carry.
I think a lot of people at home are probably asking the question, sort of what designates or dictates when Coulter goes into the game as quarterback. And we talked to Mick McCall of Northwestern about that. He said it's arbitrary, just getting into the flow and mixing him into the package.
Coulter keeps it, pitches it out, and it's a bad pitch. Ball's loose. Looks like Nebraska's got it. And they do. Will Compton, the man jumping on the football.
All week long, everyone asked me the question, does Northwestern have to play a perfect game? And I said, no, you don't have to play a perfect game, but you must play a clean game. You cannot turn the ball over, can't have penalties. So this, a deplorable start for the Cats.
Coulter's pitch a little bit wide of Tyrus Jones, and Will Compton, Johnny on the spot. So Taylor Martinez in Nebraska back on the field offensively. First down run, Burkett out to midfield. While we have a moment, the Auto Owners Insurance defense for Northwestern. Quinton Williams gets the start. Kevin Watt, the other end, he replaces Tyler Scott, who's been banged up last couple of weeks. Scott will play some. David Wabusi moves over to weak side linebacker, replacing Bryce McNall for a second straight week. Show you the secondary in a moment. Now Martinez going to test the secondary. His pass too strong. He was looking for the speedy Kenny Bell, but the pass off the fingertips.
Nebraska is definitely not afraid to let Taylor Martinez drop back and fire. And a lot of people saying, look, it's an ugly picture when he throws, and it is. I mean, just to be perfectly candid, but they will let him make every throw. They do not digress from what they do with their pass package.
On third down, Martinez struggling towards the line. He's going to be close, but I don't think he got there. Vince Brown, fifth-year senior from Ohio, makes the tackle.
You play Nebraska, you must commit to stopping the run and be consistent with it. That time, Brown does a nice job of just fighting through the traffic on the field, sniffing it out, and getting a critical stop. Great defense by Northwestern.
So that's going to force the punt team to come on for the second time in the first 8 minutes of this game. Maher had a nice rugby-style punt a moment ago. Going to try it again this time. And that one is going to go into the end zone. It will be a touchback. It'll be Northwestern's ball at the 20 when we come back.
Media timeout.
Big Ten Network Football is brought to you by the United States Marine Corps. The few, the proud, the Marines. By Auto Owners Insurance. Get to know the independent agents representing Auto Owners Insurance, the no problem people. And by MFS Investment Management. We'll be back to the capital city of Nebraska in a moment. Three early games in the books in the Big Ten. Michigan State a win today. They move to 4-1 in conference play. As we take a look at the Legends Division, Nebraska fans, all you need to know, the Cornhuskers control their destiny. If they win out during the regular year, they will advance to Indianapolis in the Big Ten championship game. Currently just two teams with one loss in the Legends Division, Michigan State and Nebraska. Nebraska's win over the Spartans nullifies Michigan State's chances if they remain tied. First down from the 20, Jeremy Ebert with the catch. He dives out to close to the 25-yard line.
Remember, one of the keys to the spread offense is to make Nebraska defend the entire field. Northwestern wants to create matchup problems with Jeremy Ebert.
Four receivers in the game. Persa in trouble. This is where he is great, folks. Persa escapes trouble and gets a first down for the Wildcats. Baker Steinkuhler on the stop, but the chains will move.
Persa has just great pocket poise. He understands when it's starting to reduce around him. He can feel the leakage coming off the edge, and he knows when to go to his feet, start to freelance.
Well, every Northwestern fan always apprehensive when Persa winces a little bit. Looked like he did on his way to the sideline. Coulter is the quarterback. Vendrick Mark his second carry, and he gets stoned. Wow, some hitting going on early in this one.
Well, and it starts with Levante David. He just works down the line of scrimmage, so athletic. He is a space player. So facing Northwestern's offense won't be as challenging to him because he can run and he's athletic, as he just showed on that play.
Senior Persa back in the game. We expect Persa and Coulter to alternate frequently throughout this game.
Look at all the spacing on the field.
Persa throws a dart low, caught. Nice reception, Charles Brown.
Northwestern wants to pass to set up the run. In their ball distribution, you will see a number of wide receivers getting involved.
Another quick snap, Persa. Plenty of time in the pocket. Now forced to throw, he throws high, but Dunsmore making the catch. Dunsmore tackled immediately, but it's a nice gain. On first down, Lance Thorell with the tackle.
You mentioned Dunsmore, and he's kind of that hybrid tight end wide receiver. They call him the super back.
Hand off, Jacob Schmidt. Crosses the 50, and he's got another first down for Northwestern. Chris, I want to talk to you about the passing attack for Northwestern. A lot of wind today with their short patterns. Is the wind still a factor or no?
Well, Persa's got velocity on his ball, so he doesn't struggle with these throws.
There's another fastball, short over the middle, but a good gain on first down to Drake Dunsmore.
And again, just high percentage throws. Working the middle of the field, you're going to see Dunsmore. He's going to sit down in the zone coverage, right in the middle. Nebraska playing that match defense, match zone.
Pick up of five. Coulter back in at quarterback, and first man through is Trayvon Green, who picks up another first down for Northwestern. Austin Cassidy, Lance Thorell combined on the stop, but once again, Northwestern driving.
And once again, Northwestern showing diversity in their attack. We've seen runs outside on the perimeter, runs inside. We've seen quick screens. We've seen outside throws. Mick McCall doing a nice job of mixing up the play selection.
Christian Jones checks in offensively, one of the wide receivers for Northwestern. They keep it on the ground. And Green, who has been featured early in this game, picks up maybe 2 yards on first down.
Well, that's been one of the keys. Northwestern really needs to get the wheels greased up for their running backs.
Well, how good was Northwestern's offense last week in Bloomington? 59 points on the Hoosiers, 610 total yards, their most in 6 years, and 5 touchdown passes, 4 of them to number 9, Drake Dunsmore. Now Persa back into the game, puts Kane Coulter in motion, bottom of your screen. Persa again with time, looking for Coulter. It's not open. He'll take it himself. And look at Persa scoot. He slides down at the 17-yard line. So difficult to try and play defense for that long against Dan Persa.
Well, anytime you can keep him clean where he has time, he's going to make you pay. Here he looks down the field, great coverage. Nothing's there. But look at the awareness. To stick it, he knows exactly where the chains are. Move them for Dan Persa.
17 yards on the ground for Persa. Coulter stays in the game at one of the receivers. He's in the slot right. Persa looks to the end zone. Incomplete. Looking for the true freshman, Christian Jones. He was working against Andrew Green, one of the corners, getting the start today for Nebraska. There's Pat Fitzgerald. Sixth year now as the coach of his alma mater, 2008 college football Hall of Famer.
And we had a chance to talk to him earlier in the week, and he said they must be consistent. Stay with their attack, don't get off schedule. So far, they've done just that.
Smith and Jones in the backfield. And the handoff is Adonis Smith, who is whacked close to the line of scrimmage. Will Compton with the tackle.
Yeah, Compton's really starting to arrive. Bo Pelini imploring his defense to take a stand here on third down. This is a defense that each week in Big Ten play, they have compressed offenses. They're not giving up a lot of yardage. So far, Northwestern getting some chunks.
Looks like Nebraska a little bit confused. They're trying to call timeout, and they get it.
Timeout.
Big play, Nebraska. Third down and eight.
They're first.
Northwestern trying to keep the offense on the field. We'll see what they draw up when we come back to Lincoln. BTN introduces BTN Live Big, the initiative to recognize and inspire community service efforts throughout the Big Ten and the world. To live big is to find a cause that you're passionate about and do something about it. Don't miss an all-new BTN Live Big, hosted by Dahana Jones and presented by Buick, Monday at 7:30 Eastern on BTN. All right, after the Nebraska timeout, third down and eight, line to get is the five. Person out of the gun, in trouble, throws it incomplete. Oh, Levante David got in and pressured Persa. There is a late flag down on the field. Ciante Evans may be whistled.
Well, Evans is the nickelback. Here he's working against Ebert.
Now here's our referee, Dave Whitbo.
Pass interference. Defense from the 17. Spot foul on the minute, first down.
So the pass interference keeps Northwestern's offense on the field.
Well, you see a lot of hand play right in the center of the frame. I think that's a good call. Evans playing it aggressively. There's the defensive coordinator, Carl Pelini.
He didn't think it was a good call.
Either way, they got to line up and get a stop here.
So it's first and goal for Northwestern. Purser, the quarterback, Schmidt behind him. They give it to Schmidt, and Jacob Schmidt scores. Jacob Schmidt, the touchdown. And Northwestern grabs the early lead.
And you see a Northwestern team that has come in here very confident in what they do on offense, despite going up against a stalwart defense. They methodically work the ball down the field, sustaining a long drive and capping it off with a touchdown.
Now five rushing touchdowns on the year for the fifth-year senior, Jacob Schmidt. Jeff Budzine will come on and attempt the extra point. Budzine had a lot of practice a week ago. He went 8 for 8 on extra points against the Hoosiers. All right, Dan Persa leads the drive down the field. Jacob Schmidt caps it off with a touchdown, 7-0 Northwestern. Northwestern on top of Nebraska, 7-0. Jacob Schmidt had a big game a week ago against Indiana. Off to a good start today. He runs it in from 2 yards out. Northwestern has a team now with 9 first downs. Nebraska, they've got 1.
Well, they've been productive on first down, which is putting them into manageable third downs. You look at the probability, much greater conversion ratio. But this is an offense that has a lot of firepower.
Steve Flaherty will kick it off. Flaherty's got a big leg, and he's got the wind at his back right now. I would be surprised if this football stays in the field of play.
Be surprised if it stays on the tee. That wind's cutting through there.
Take it out. And Bell, with a full head of steam, is tackled as he crosses the 20. Let's go to Dave Revson in the studio for Discover Card Game Break.
All right, Eric, thanks. A walk-on from the state of Wisconsin scoring in your game, and another doing the same in Madison. Russell Wilson to Jared Abradaris, 14-7 Badgers over the Boilermakers.
Thanks, Dave. All the home teams have won so far today around the conference. Right now, the home team, the Cornhuskers, in trouble, down 7-0. Burkhead runs right smack dab into the arms of Quinton Williams and Will Hampton.
That's just good, tenacious defense inside. They know Burkhead likes to get behind his pads. Northwestern right in the teeth of that defense. Have to be strong at the point of attack.
Bears mentioning Burkhead, a career-high 35 carries a week ago. How fresh will he be 7 days later? Martinez spins it out. He was about to be tackled, but he makes something out of nothing. Burkhead out to the 40-yard line. It was Quinton Williams who had Martinez in his arms, but just couldn't bring him down.
Well, Martinez going back to his California playground day here. He's going to feel the pressure. He's going to slide up. But then this is just a little improv. Get rid of it to Burkhead. Nice job.
Another quick snap trying to catch Northwestern napping and didn't work. Jordan Maben comes in from his corner spot and tackles Burkhead.
Thing about Burkhead is he leaks out a lot of yards after initial contact. So you got to wrap him up. Like I said, get a lot of population. Northwestern has to get all 11 guys to the ball.
Martinez completes that pass to Kinney once again. Kinney's second catch, and he has enough for a Nebraska first down.
That time, Tim Beck, offensive coordinator of Nebraska, says, you want to stack the box? We're going to see if your corners can hold up then. But you look at Kinney, he's a big physical wide receiver at 6'3", 230 pounds. Good job getting the defender off.
Burkhead picks up 5 yards on first down, maybe four. And we're under a minute to play here in the first quarter. Windy afternoon here in Lincoln, Nebraska. Northwestern and Nebraska playing for the first time here in Lincoln since 1974. Last time they played was actually down in San Antonio in the Alamo Bowl after the 2000 regular season. That game was won handily, to say the least, by Nebraska. But right now, they're in trouble. After 15 minutes of play, the homestanding Nebraska Cornhuskers trailing Northwestern by a score of 7-0. Nebraska's on the move. Back to Lincoln in a moment. Start of the second quarter, Northwestern on top of Nebraska, 7-0. Northwestern, some disappointment this year. At one point, losing 5 straight games until last week's win over Indiana. Second down and 6. Rex Burkhead powers over the 40-yard line down to the 39. It'll bring up 3rd down and 2. Well, 15 minutes in the books. So far, offense not a problem for Northwestern. They have 118 yards of total offense, just 68 for Nebraska. I guess Nebraska fortunate that Northwestern turned it over. Bad pitch. And the quarterback, Kane Coulter.
Northwestern's been playing well on 3rd down.
Option football out of space. Burkhead, the 1st down and more. Pushed out of bounds, close to the 30-yard line.
This is a good job of negotiating the option here by Martinez. There's the pitch defender. Good relationship with Burkhead. Delivery.
So 1st down and 10. Burkhead stays in the game. They fake it to him. Martinez wants to throw as the wind at his back, and his pass is incomplete. Looking for Kenny Bell. Looked like that could have been catchable for Bell.
Yeah, and if you're a wide receiver for Nebraska, you really got to work for your quarterback. You got to understand that balls are going to come to you outside of your frame. And if you're Bell, you got to go down and make the tough catch. This is an opportunity for Nebraska to move the sticks. Difficult catch, certainly one he should make. Not even that difficult.
There's a ball in the first quarter that went Kenny Bell's way that he didn't have a catch on either. Designed quarterback run, Martinez. picks up 7 yards. Let's go down to the field. Dion, what's the latest with Northwestern?
Well, Eric, you mentioned Pat Fitzgerald saying the disappointment this team has had, and he's been very open about the fact he thinks they need to coach better. Well, in an effort to do that, he's grabbed the whiteboard several times, gathered up those linebackers, and drawn up adjustments, saying we need someone to be a playmaker on this defense.
It's fair to say Pat Fitzgerald, the greatest linebacker to ever play at Northwestern. Look at the playmaking ability. Taylor Martinez scooting past Brian Peters and picks up a Nebraska first down.
Well, Dion's report was a great nugget. You know why? It's because Nebraska, they don't run a lot of different plays, but they give you different looks. It's a multiple offense. It's a lot of window dressing. And so the key is making those early adjustments.
So Martinez picks up the first down for Nebraska. They line up in a two tight end formation. The eye back, Burkhead. Martinez wants to throw, in trouble. Gets it out to a safety valve. This is Kinney. Kinney's third catch, and he spins down to the 13-yard line.
Kinney takes a shot there. Here, Martinez just going to the check down. A lot of the white jerseys of Northwestern flowing to the football.
Well, Chance Carter had a chance to knock down Brandon Kinney. He took it. Hopefully, Kinney's okay.
Yeah, and Kinney's been playing a lot better the last couple of weeks. We talked to Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator at Nebraska, said he got off to a slow start. A little bit of that senior mentality. But he saw some of the young, talented freshman wide receivers pushing him, and now he stepped up his level of play.
Kyrie Cooper now in the game, replacing Kinney. Option football. Burkhead has the first down, pushed out of bounds inside the five. Ibrahim Campbell with the tackle. But another first down for Nebraska.
Well, just vintage Cornhusker football. There's the pitch guy. Negotiate. Get it to Burkhead. He's your bell cow. And allow him to do what he does. Burkhead has been the guy, especially when they get in the red zone. This is power football. Give him a fullback and let him tote the rock.
Brandon Kinney back in the game for Nebraska, but they stay on the ground. Burkhead loses the football. Looks like Northwestern has it. Tyler Scott. What a fortunate bounce. Bounce right in his arms.
And unfortunate for Burkhead, who now in his second week inside the red zone, coughs up the ball. And that is a drive killer for Nebraska. But look at Northwestern hustling to the ball, closing down the run lanes. That's a major turnover and a shot of adrenaline to the Wildcats. See if they can capitalize on it.
Northwestern has the ball inside their own five when we come back. Nebraska trailing Northwestern 7-0. Rex Burkhead, his first fumble lost this season. Happened just a moment ago. Of course, last week he fumbled on the goal line against Michigan State. It was overturned, and it was a Nebraska score. But he loses this one, and Northwestern has the football. First down carry, Jacob Schmidt for a short gain.
Northwestern going to go back to their attack outside, look for Ebert Dunsmore to get involved in this series. Pepper in a little Kane Coulter.
Persa joined by Schmidt in the backfield. Superback Dunsmore goes in motion. Persa wants to throw. Designed rollout. Now reverses his field. Basically gets back to the line of scrimmage, but it looked pretty. Guy just scoots around. It's like he's covered with Vaseline sometimes.
The key with him, though, is he always keeps his eyes down the field, and that's how he's able to make those plays. Northwestern gets so many yards with their receivers off of Dan Persa scrambles.
Six defensive backs now on the field for Nebraska. Persa's pass is caught, but Demetrius Fields, no chance at all. Wrapped up on the spot, Alfonso Dennard.
There's a lot of guys that I would throw at against Nebraska. Alfonso Denner is not one of them. And he is a true all-American cornerback, probably the top three in college football. Very physical, believes in his technique. He challenges wide receivers. Great job of making a play and getting off the field.
Now, Brandon Williams didn't punt until the fourth quarter last week. Now getting onto the field here in the first half. His punt low. Abdullah calls for the fair catch and makes it. But it's great starting field position for Nebraska. It will start on the 48-yard line. Let's go to Dave Revson in the studio for Discover Card Game Break.
Eric, thanks. Wisconsin has scored again. Monty Ball, his national best, 22nd touchdown of the year. It's 21-10, Badger.
Thanks, Dave. So the trend continues. All the home teams doing well today around the conference, except for right now, Nebraska trailing 7-0. Still plenty of time. 10 minutes and change here in this second quarter. Late handoff. No, Martinez keeps it. And Martinez picks up 6 yards on first down.
He does a nice job of hiding that football. Martinez that time faking the dive to Burkhead. Able to pull it in. He's an incredible athlete as well. Great linear speed, vision. Look how closely Northwestern, their linebackers are. They're really stacking that box.
Martinez has a wide open man. Ball is loose. Anunua had it, then lost it. Ball still loose. Northwestern says they have it, and they do. They're going to call that a catch and then a fumble, and it's going to be the second turnover in as many drives for Nebraska.
We talked about the importance of Northwestern creating opportunities. Here yet again, a big play for the Cats, taking the momentum from Nebraska.
Catch is made by Anunua. Does he make the football move? Looks like he did. Balls pop loose. Northwestern ball when we come back. Seven nothing Northwestern over Nebraska moments ago. Quincy Anunua fumbling the football on the hit by Jervin Matthews.
Well, look how Matthews clubs the ball, and that's outstanding. He's been targeted this season. You want to get teams to stop throwing at you? Make plays like that.
The play was looked at a little longer by the replay official during the break, and call on the field was correct. Catch and a fumble. Persa keeping the play alive. In trouble. Tackled from behind. Baker Steinkuhler. Right at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of a yard.
The Cornhuskers secondary. Extremely athletic and proficient on the back end. That time, just great coverage down the field. Nothing there. He looked at Ebert. Went through the progression. Coulter's blanketed. Good defense.
Second down and 9. Low and outside, incomplete, looking for Jeremy Ebert. He had two Cornhusker defenders trailing him.
And that's a great matchup. That's Ebert and Denner inside. Northwestern strength on Nebraska strength. We'll have to watch that game within the game. That's an exciting one.
First a week ago against Indiana, close to flawless. 16 of 20, 80% passing, 261 yards, and the 3 touchdown passes. In trouble here, third down and 9. Line to get is the 29. Persa breaks the pocket and just has to throw it away, and he is down in pain. It was Eric Martin on the pressure, and Persa still down on the ground.
Well, the one thing Martin can do is bend the corner and get after the quarterback. And that time, just relentless in his pursuit. Standing up, coming off the edge, good hands, disengage with the tackle. And look at the burst, the suddenness. Slamming Persa down to the ground. So that left shoulder being driven into the turf.
So all eyes right now for Northwestern. Looking at that sideline, Dan Persa, such a special player. Williams, another punt. Line drive, Abdullah. Tackled at the 32-yard line, a late flag dropped in. Benrick Mark on the tackle.
Looked like a block in the back against Nebraska. Northwestern doing a good job of hustling down the field to get to Abdullah. Officials convening to get it right.
There is no penalty. The block in question was a side block. First down.
So they pick up the flag. No movement, no penalty. And Bo Pelini's team will have the ball on offense. Last two times they've had, Chris, they have turned it over with fumbles. One by Burkhead, the most recent fumble by Anunua.
And you know what's important is where they turned it over. On or inside the red zone, taking points off the board, potentially critical points.
Pat Fitzgerald pleading his case. Power formation now. For Nebraska, two tight ends. They run Burkhead right side. Burkhead out to about the 33. Let's go down on the field. Dion, what's the latest?
Well, that Nebraska offense trying to rally the troops. The coaches speaking with them, asking them to, quote unquote, get it fixed now. They're saying you've got to find a fire inside. Finish plays, finish runs, finish the catch, and finish this, guys.
Thank you, Dion. Burkhead has just left the game. Abdullah replaces him as the I back. And Martinez throws it and completes it right side. Brandon Kinney, good to see him back on the field making the catch. Kinney now with four catches.
Well, you know they're an offensive juggernaut, particularly on the ground. I think the message for this offense is ball secured.
Another pass. This time the tight end Cotton with the grab. First down, ball spotted at the 47.
Cotton's a big target at 6'6", just under 260 pounds. Gives Martinez a little more room or margin for error. Good completion.
Burkhead, first down carry across the 50 to the 46. So Burkhead may be feeling it a little bit now, as the Cornhuskers once again driving down the field on the Wildcats.
And once again running between the tackles. Great blocking up front to create clear running lanes for Burkhead.
Once again, two tight ends, and Martinez wants to throw out of it. Incomplete, there is a flag down. Looking for Kyler Reed, but a flag coming out in the secondary.
Ineligible downfield, number 25. Five-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Well, it's going to go against Nebraska, and that continues to be a problem for Bo Pelini's team. Penalties. We saw it a year ago with the Cornhuskers. More of the same this year. Last week, really the only negative for the Cornhuskers in their win against Michigan State. Nine penalties in that game. Second time in the last month that they had nine penalties in a game. That's a lot.
Yeah, self-inflicting wounds. Unforced errors. And that's what has Coach Pelini so heated.
Martinez has already thrown the football 10 times. He's 8 for 10 throwing. Make it 9 for 11. Kenny Bell has the football, and Bell tackled at the 45. Good open field tackle made by Colin Ellis.
I love watching Kenny Bell. He's just one of those guys that when he has the ball in his hand, you sort of hold your breath to see what he's going to do. He's only a redshirt freshman, but he plays bigger. Great in space, explosive. Has that versatility that you look for.
Pitch right side. Burkhead stalled, spins forward. David Rapusi is going to make it a third down. No, it's going to make it a fourth down. Fourth down and two with the ball spotted at the 45. Fans want the Huskers to go for it, but Bo Pelini's already sent out the punt team.
Well, Coach Pelini looking at those numbers, Northwestern's defense holding up on third downs. Clearly, this is an easy call.
Hot. Maher's punt lands at the 8 and skips into the end zone. second touchback. So Northwestern will start at the 20. Will Dan Persa be on the field? The Buick Human Highlight Reel celebrates former NCAA athletes doing great things in their community. Let's take a look at one of those stories now. Northwestern on top of Nebraska, 7-0. Dan Persa, he was taken down last time the Wildcats had the ball. Eric Martin, just dragging him to the ground. Looked like that left shoulder was a bit of an issue. He was looked at on the sideline. Persa is back in at quarterback right now. True freshman running back, Trayvon Green next to him. Persa wants to throw. Too high, looking for Jeremy Ebert, and once again, Persa hits the deck.
And what I love about Nebraska's pass rush is they're doing it with discipline. They're getting up the field, sort of putting a fence around Dan Persa to keep him inside. They know that he's dangerous when he gets outside of those hash marks.
Saw Cameron Meredith looking on, number 34. They say he is the next great superstar of the defensive line here at Nebraska. Nowhere to go at all for Trayvon Green. Lance Storrell with the stop. Let's take a look at our peak antifreeze quarterback comparison.
Well, you know, you got two tremendous athletes, both capable of doing damage with their feet, both being very judicious with the football so far. No turnovers.
Chris, are you as surprised as I am how many passes we've seen with this windy of a day?
Well, you're trusting the arm strength of your quarterback. And these have been manageable throws. We're not seeing a ton of vertical routes. Both guys have the velocity on intermediate cuts.
Play clock down to one. Northwestern just gets it off. Persa with a laser. It's caught by Ebert. First down, Northwestern. Now, Persa, not a huge quarterback, listed at 6'1", 210, but he can sure get it out there in a hurry.
And has more velocity than you think. He's an anticipatory passer, and so he looks for those cuts and he throws at spots.
First down at 10, Dunsmore, the super back in motion. They gave it to Schmidt. Schmidt tackled by Lance Thorell. Well, big news here. In Lincoln, Nebraska earlier this week on Monday, after that stellar defensive performance by Nebraska over Michigan State, coaching staff handing out those coveted black shirts, handed out 21 of them. That is a big deal at Nebraska football.
Oh yeah, dating way back. But it's time for this defense to take a stand. This crowd's getting into the game. They know this is a critical series.
Coulter in the game, running in motion. Persa looks his way. Pass batted up in the air, live football. And Levante David has picked it off.
When you get short throws, intermediate cuts, the ball has a low trajectory. So when you can't get to the quarterback, you get the hands up. Good rush right up front. Excellent job. Steinkuhler using that 6'6 length. Batted up, Levante David always hustling to the football. Big turnover for Nebraska.
So the Cornhuskers struggling. They get the black shirts to change the momentum. Second interception of the season for David. And Ben Cotton now with a nice gain on first down. The tight end, his second grab. And that's going to be a first down for Nebraska. Pickup of 13.
Nice play selection by Tim Beck. Off of a turnover, you want to attack the Cats defense.
Nebraska, two timeouts at their disposal. They try Burkett, and Burkett struggles forward for a couple of yards.
Looks like Kenny Bell's slow to get up on that one.
Bell stays in the game. Marlowe and Kinney, the other receivers. Nebraska not in any kind of a hurry. Plenty of time. 3 minutes and change here in our second quarter. Quick pass. McKinney with the reception. His fifth catch of this first half.
See Tim Beck mixing it up, being aggressive here. See if he comes back to the run, or does he work these isolation matchups outside?
Third down and four. I don't think take the ball out of Taylor Martinez's hands. He runs option over to Burkhead. Nowhere to go. Busted up David Wabusi, forcing that play wide.
Well defended by Northwestern. Nebraska executing the pitch. Wabusi, the second layer, doing a nice job closing to the football and getting Burkhead on the ground.
Now Nebraska doesn't turn it over this time in the red zone, but they're going to be forced to settle for a field goal, it appears.
Oh, yeah. Opportunities that have slipped through early for Nebraska. They need these points.
Brett Maher has not missed inside the 50 so far this year. This a 36-yard attempt. With the wind, no worries at all. So the Cornhuskers on the board for the first time. They still trail Northwestern 7-3. Thursday night to experience a football weekend like never before with Tailgate 48. Get an all-access pass to Big Ten campuses for a 48-hour tour of the traditions and game day excitement. Tailgate 48, presented by Omaha Steaks, Thursday at 7 p.m. Eastern time on BTN. 36-yard field goal by Brett Maher. Now he'll kick it off. He'll have the wind at his back. 2:26 to play here in the first half.
Yeah, that was actually a win for both teams. Nebraska getting some points on the board, but Northwestern keeping them out of the end zone and maintaining their lead.
Northwestern wants Fenrick Mark to return this. He's number five. One of the better returners in the country. The ball doesn't go to him. It goes to Jacob Schmidt. And Schmidt takes an eight. It'll be Northwestern ball at the 20. Stay tuned for the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. Dave, Jerry, and Howard will be along from our Chicago studio with scores and highlights from all today's action.
Eric, it's so intriguing watching these matchups, particularly inside where Northwestern has a very talented wide receiving core, but Nebraska's secondary certainly the strength. And then Levante David inside, just great individual matchups.
Northwestern has been a good first half team. All five of their losses so far this year, they've had the lead in the second half. Right now they lead by four, getting close to intermission.
You hear me say too high. Look at the safeties, how high they are, how back they are.
Persa getting happy feet in the pocket, just having to get out of dodge. He does, he's got room. Look at Persa, close to the first down marker. Eric Martin stops him, but a pickup of nine.
And exactly what causes defensive coordinators heartburn. That time they had him boxed in, but watch him, he's patient, keeps his eyes down the field, but he knows when to get out of trouble. And he can just sniff out run lanes, make a bad play a good play.
Second time that Eric Martin has tackled Persa, and Persa's come up holding his left shoulder. So Persa on the sideline, Coulter hands it off to Adonis Smith, and it's a short gain. It's going to be second down and nine.
Well, certainly one of the benefits of having that two quarterback system. You got a guy in Coulter who has great familiarity with the offense, so you're not throwing him out there cold. But he's got to keep Northwestern ahead of the chains so they can get into third and short.
Coulter, a guy who was recruited by Nebraska. They wanted him. Just decided to play Northwestern instead. On second down, he decides to run it, and he is wrapped up and tackled. Steinkuhler again with those long arms.
One key word on Coulter, how about position versatility? He can sit back there and spin it outside, but he's a tremendous athlete. So you have to put the ball in his hands because he can make teams pay from a variety of positions.
Look at that. He's thrown the football 72 times. He's caught the football 21 times. And oh yes, he's run on the ground for 459 yards and six touchdowns.
Well, he's one of those guys, he has that fast twitch. And Northwestern typically doesn't get a lot of those guys that have that type of explosiveness.
Their first 30-second timeout.
Northwestern calls a timeout. Just letting that clock wind down. Playing keep away right now. Making sure that if they're not going to score, they don't want to give Nebraska time on the clock so they can score before halftime. And while we have a moment, how about we take a look at our Case IH spotlight, and it features former Nebraska defensive lineman Kyle Vandenbosch. These are pictures from back in the 2000 Alamo Bowl against Northwestern. He was just all over Zach Kustak, Damian Anderson, and Northwestern. In that game, seven tackles, he had a sack, six quarterback hurries, even broke up a couple of passes. Still playing with the Detroit Lions. They have a bye week this week.
Be interesting to see if Northwestern goes conservative here with 39 seconds before halftime.
Coulter's still in the game at quarterback. They do go conservative, and Coulter's going to make it pay off. Coulter's going to have enough for the first down. He gets out of bounds, and that'll stop the clock.
Just a natural runner. Watch the feel here. No hurry. He just sifts and sorts, waits for the lane, and then hits it.
The clock stops, 32 seconds. Northwestern has two timeouts. Coulter looking for the super back. Dunsmore, it's too far. Oh, he had a step on Lance Thorell.
Well, Nebraska going to that dime defense that they've been in much of today. Thorell coming in. That's a matchup that you'll take that shot, because Dunsmore's a tough cover.
Coulter last week, a bit of everything against Indiana. You could say that for a lot of guys offensively for Northwestern. They put up 59 points on the Hoosiers. Coulter in trouble, goes down. Wow, it was one whack to the arm by Baker Steinkuhler, and Coulter goes down.
Talk about hand strength. In physicality, Steinkuhler, who's really stepped up his play since Jared Crick has been out. Look how he just drives back. The offensive lineman may have been tangled up with his teammate.
Well, that's going to do it. Northwestern just going to say, you know what? We're happy to have the lead. Dan Persa and Northwestern on top of Nebraska 7-3. Stay tuned for the Buffalo Wild Wings halftime report. Dave, Jerry, and Howard, they're coming up next. This was at the end of the second quarter, holding that left shoulder. Will he be able to play it here? Dan Persa, very vital to this offense for Northwestern. They lead 7-3, getting ready for our third quarter to get underway. Northwestern a week ago, mainly because of Dan Persa and that offense, just building up a ton of confidence with their win over Indiana. Let's go down on the field. Deion Miller with the absolute latest. Deion.
Well, Pat Fitzgerald very pleased so far with his defense coming up with those two turnovers. He said that have been the difference so far. He said we've got to remain consistent, keep tackling, keep fighting, and keep playing. As for Dan Persa, very tight-lipped about his current condition, other than to say he's clearly tough as nails. He wants to play and is not 100%, so we'll wait and see. As for Bo Pelini, he says we have got to fix us in the second half. We have got to play our game and stop shooting ourselves in the foot. They have all season been a second half team. We'll see what kind of adjustments they once again make, Eric.
Thank you, Deion. Yeah, you can make the argument they turned their season around with that second half comeback they had against Ohio State a couple of weeks ago.
Well, I think Tim Beck, the offensive coordinator of Nebraska, he likes to keep some plays in his back pocket for the second half. So you'll see some things that we didn't necessarily see the first half, see if that can loosen up the Wildcat defense.
Northwestern, their offense revolves around their fifth-year senior, Dan Persa. He was tackled on two separate occasions by Eric Martin. Both times came up favoring that left shoulder.
Well, anytime you get a quarterback that likes to scramble, he's susceptible to a lot of contact. And this is a physical Nebraska defense, and they want to make him pay when he breaks down and tries to get outside.
Dan Persa spends about 2.5 hours, 5 days a week, rehabbing his Achilles that he tore last November in a game against Iowa. That's been a big part of his last year, and now dealing with what appears to be a shoulder injury. Before we kick this off here in the third quarter, let's take a look at our five-hour energy. First half stats, as you'd imagine, Northwestern putting up some good numbers. They had 160 yards of total offense, 181 yards of total offense for Nebraska, but they're not able to score, largely because of two turnovers.
Well, ball security is certainly an issue, but also third downs for Nebraska. You want that number to be north of 50%. See if they can get the conversion rate show here in the second half.
Wind once again is a factor. Told you about it all afternoon long. Gusts up to 30 miles per hour. It's coming basically from right behind the south end zone. So the wind will be at the back of the kicker, Maher, as he kicks this one off. Makes it to the goal line. Vendrick Mark is going to bring it out. Mark slips the first wave of defenders, and Mark on his feet out to the 40-yard line. Special teams tackle made by Eric Martin, but a return of 41 yards.
And sometimes when you have a little hiccup back there, it gets guys out of their lanes. No longer lane integrity. Mark does a nice job of finding the crease, has that second gear to get chunks of yardage. Northwestern's going to have tremendous starting field position for Kane Coulter.
Yep, but they're going to have their backup quarterback in. No Dan Persa to begin this drive. Trayvon Green is the tailback, and Green has it. Busts forward out to the 47-yard line. Steinkuhler, who's had a solid game, wraps him up and makes the tackle.
Folks at home may be wondering how this changes Northwestern's play selection. It really won't. Coulter's capable of executing the playbook, same plays that would be called for Dan Persa.
Another run to Green, and he's swarmed by Steinkuhler. This guy, coaching staff believes he's going to be a left tackle in the NFL, but for right now, he's a heck of a defensive tackle.
And because he's feisty. But it's rare to have his type of length on the college level. He's every bit of 6'6". You don't see that for defensive tackles. And you can feel the energy in this crowd imploring their defense to get a stop.
New quarterback now. This is Trevor Siemian. So Northwestern goes three deep at quarterback. And Siemian, who's got a big arm, throws it on third down, and he completes it. Jeremy Ebert, the first down and a bunch more, finally tackled at the 25-yard line. So in a passing situation, they take Coulter out, and they put in Siemian.
And you say bringing a quarterback and Siemian and allowing him to pull the trigger, but they know he's got a big-time arm with some velocity. And any time you get Ebert matched up against Thorell, Northwestern likes that matchup.
Siemian stays in the game. Coulter also in the game as a receiver. They get it to him. And Coulter tackled immediately by Lance Thorell.
And again, Northwestern identifying matchup problems. Siemian coming out of the game. He did his work. See if Nebraska can do some work to get off the field.
And now Northwestern, unusual formation. They send Mulroe way out to the right, and it confuses Northwestern, confuses Nebraska, and Kanapka scores. What an unusual formation. There's a flag down on the field. Nebraska was obviously confused, and the backup tight end, Konopka, scoring the touchdown.
And judging from the reaction of Coulter, this is going to go against Northwestern. As he walked over and heard the officials.
Ineligible downfield, number 83 offense. 83 is covered. 5-yard penalty, repeat second down.
Northwestern took one of their guards, Brian Mulroe, number 72. And before the snap, they took Mulroe out of the line of scrimmage, the pit area, and Konopka was the ineligible man. So wipe away the score, and it's now second down and 12.
The damage there, now you've sort of shown your hand and given up your trick play, so to speak.
First penalty of the afternoon for the Wildcats. Coulter. He throws over the middle. It's caught. Dunsmore still on his feet. That'll be a first down for Northwestern.
You just can't emphasize enough two things. One, the value of Drake Dunsmore. And then two, able to find the hole in the defense. Nebraska lives and dies with that cover two defense. They vacate the middle of the field, so when you have a hybrid player like Dunsmore, he's tough to cover inside. Northwestern has been exploiting that often today.
Dunsmore in motion. The tailback is Schmidt. Coulter keeps it. Nobody open. Just going to try and get to the edge. Dives to the pylon.
Carried by Coulter. That's up.
He's going to be short of the marker. It'll be spotted at the one.
Coulter trying to get there. Good lateral pursuit by Nebraska.
Wow.
The result of the play was a touchdown.
They're going to score that a touchdown. Coulter got the ball on the pylon. What an athletic play by the sophomore Coulter.
Watch the extension. Look at that. Absolute thing of beauty. Nice shot. Great extension.
We've got an official timeout. That's Jack
Konopka. Is that the player dove, reached out and touched the pylon with the ball, resulting in a touchdown. The previous play is under further review.
True freshman tight end Jack Konopka is the Northwestern Wildcat down on the field.
By virtue of the rule, that ball hits the pylon, it's a touchdown. Look at the balance and body control. Just an outstanding individual effort.
Injured player still on the field. We'll take a timeout. It appears Northwestern has opened up a 10-point lead. Jack Konopka being helped off the field during that last brief interlude. The replay official with the verdict that is indeed a touchdown for Kane Coulter and Northwestern.
Yeah, we get to see it again here. And Nebraska has to realize they are in a fight, and right now they're taking a lot of body punches. Coach Pelini knows it.
So Northwestern takes the football and drives the field without Dan Persa, using Kane Coulter and Trevor Siemian to put a touchdown on the board. But Zine's extra point is true. Largest lead of the day, Northwestern and Kane Coulter on top of Nebraska, 14-3. Northwestern on top of Nebraska, 14-3 is our score. Wildcats taking the opening kickoff of this third quarter and putting it in for seven. This is a Northwestern team that lost on the road at Army, then proceeded to lose five consecutive games in total. Only conference win coming a week ago in Bloomington, Indiana against the Hoosiers. They are leading Nebraska by 11. Steve Flaherty to kick it off. Nebraska looking for a spark. This is Kenny Bell. And Bell spins out to the 39-yard line. Good starting field position for the Huskers.
Bell is an electrifying returner. Good play there, setting it up for Nebraska's offense, and this offense got to crank it up. Watch his vision and then explosiveness. This is going to be a great one before he leaves Lincoln.
Cornhuskers, 181 yards of offense in the first half, but only 3 points. Quarterback keeper Martinez gets to the edge and goes out of bounds on his own volition. Good first down play for Nebraska.
Well, option football, and those, the keeper's predicated on getting outside on the perimeter. Martinez dialing up his own number to get the first down.
Martinez had 16 yards rushing in the first half. That was a gain of 19. This time, maybe should have handed it off. Kevin Watt with the tackle. It's going to be a loss of 4.
Nice job by Watt being disciplined, staying home and getting Martinez on the ground. That's a big play for the Cats.
With Chris Martin and Deion Miller, I'm Eric Collins. Nebraska, 3-1 in the Legends Division, taking on Northwestern with just one conference win. So far, it has been Northwestern's game. Northwestern trying to win here in Lincoln, Nebraska, a place they haven't played in since 1974, just doing enough good things, even without their starting quarterback, Dan Persa. This carry by Burkhead doesn't result in much. It's going to bring a third down and long.
Now the trick is obviously a passing down for the Cornhuskers. See what they can conjure up.
Four receivers in the game. Northwestern showing blitz. Northwestern does not blitz. Martinez, pass is complete. Tyree Cooper, his first catch of the game, short of the first down marker, but it may be close enough where Nebraska will go for it.
But just smart defense, though. Defend the sticks. Third down, you know where Nebraska needs to get to. Keep it in front of you, come up, make the play. Now you put Nebraska's offense up against it. And a harrowing fourth down.
It'd be a 50-yard field goal, but instead they're going to go for it. No chance. Burkhead trapped from behind. Kenton Williams with the tackle.
And Jack DiNardo with great penetration. How do you stop these run plays? You get penetration. Look at that line. Backs making moves in the backfield. They hate that. Excellent play up front by Northwestern to get their offense back out on the field.
Eighth time with the football today for the offense of Northwestern. It starts with a run. Jacob Schmidt barrels forward for a pickup of 3. Fifth year senior from Wisconsin. Once again, Northwestern playing without Dan Persa. Out with that shoulder injury. We're told he's questionable as to whether or not he can come back.
Well, you see he's in obvious pain still. Northwestern, you want to eat this clock. Lots of run plays.
Coulter keeps it, doesn't pitch it, and he is tripped up. Will Compton on the tackle. It'll bring up a third down. Third down situation. Trevor Siemian back in at quarterback for Northwestern. Crossing pattern, Coulter has the first down, maybe more. Coulter still on his feet and out of bounds at the 25.
the great thing about the versatility of Coulter is he knows where the routes are supposed to be. So he can see it through the eyes of a quarterback, through the eyes of a receiver. That time just working the underneath route across the field, giving Simeon time, delivers a strike.
So Simeon back to the sideline. Coulter takes the snap, hands it off. Schmidt tackled at the line of scrimmage by Lamonte David. Now this would be the signature win Pat Fitzgerald's Wildcats are looking for.
Well, they have seemed unfazed all day about this Nebraska defense.
Coulter to throw, plenty of time. Pass incomplete, looking for Dunsmore.
Bo Pelini wanted a holding call. He was irate on the sideline. And just too far outside, but not bad ball placement. That's where you want it, outside and low. Big down here for Northwestern. Can they convert? They've done well on third downs today.
Coulter will be throwing into the wind.
Middle of the field.
They keep it on the ground. Coulter, he is tackled well short of the first down marker. Lance Terrell with the tackle. It'll bring up fourth down. And is this a decision for Northwestern?
Well, they're going to be kicking against the wind, correct, if they go for the field goal.
Yeah, there's no sign that they're going to kick. They're going to go for it here on fourth down, it appears.
Well, I think that's the reason to make that decision. And you've been quite successful.
Ebert, the man in motion, number 11, dangerous in these situations. Coulter with time, looking for Ebert. Did he get enough? It's going to depend on the spot. Ebert with the catch right at the marker before heading out of bounds.
What about the great field awareness by Ebert? I think he gets it easily.
He did. They've already moved the markers. They're not even going to measure it. It's going to be a first down for Northwestern.
Watch the end of this play. Looking right at the marker. Does a good job of sliding to get that first down.
Now maybe we'll take a longer look.
Ruling on the previous play was a completed catch on a first down. The previous play is under further review.
Now Pat Fitzgerald and Northwestern would have loved to have got off another play and not have to worry about a review. But it's not to be the case. Replay official wants a longer look just to make sure if the first down was indeed achieved.
And for all you youngsters at home watching, when your coaches tell you about field awareness, this is what they're talking about. Understanding where you're at. Ebert up against the sideline, making a subtle slide to what I believe gets Northwestern a first down.
Yeah, if the toe had slipped and gone out of bounds with his left foot, he was short of the first down marker, but he was able to keep his 2 feet in, it appeared, and was able to stretch forward and get on the other side of the first down marker.
This is a Nebraska defense that has been on the field for great lengths of time. You wonder if they're starting to wear down. Watching Nebraska, studying their defense, truly one of the best defenses in the conference, particularly the way they've been playing in the last 2 weeks after
the
bye.
After further review, the ruling on the field stands, a catch and a first down.
So there you have it. Fourth down play is converted by Coulter and Ebert. And Northwestern will have a fresh set of downs on Nebraska's 15.
This is where the seniors of Nebraska's defense, Lavonte David, those guys, they got to get their guys up.
Simeon back in at quarterback. Five receiver formation. Throwing to the end zone. basket off of Coulter's fingers. It's Nebraska football. Austin Cassidy on the run out, still on his feet. Cassidy to the 50-yard line. How about that? Nebraska takes it back. Northwestern felt they needed to do it, but they got greedy, Chris.
Well, then no doubt they did, and I love the fact that Nebraska, they eyeballed Coulter. They knew that's where Northwestern was going with the ball. Cassidy makes a nice play on it. When you bring a quarterback in who throws 100% of the time, you play that tendency.
Burkett crackled around the ankles after a 5-yard gain. No, that quite possibly is the break that Nebraska so desperately needed.
Now this offense has to capitalize on that big turnover.
Speedster Jamal Turner checks into the game. He's number 10. They go for Quincy and Unwin. Now they check down, and the catch is made by Kenny Bell. In the area was an Unwin, but instead Martinez hits Kenny Bell. Big gainer, another first down for Nebraska.
And a nice ball strike by Taylor Martinez. Hitting Bell right on the numbers.
Burkett, right side. Another good gain on first down.
This is where Nebraska is going to get back to what they do best. Downhill, physical running. Keep feeding Burkett.
False start, offense, number 61. 5-yard penalty, the down remains second.
So another penalty going against Nebraska. Stick around tonight after the final drive. It's a special encore presentation of BTN's Icon Series. We look at Nebraska's legendary football coach, Tom Osborne. Big Ten Icons, the coaches presented by Discover later today. This is Burkett, and Burkett pushed out of bounds by David Wabusi. Big Ten Icons, the coaches tonight following the final drive only on BTN. Nebraska down by 11, 5 minutes and change left here in the third quarter. Quick hitter over the middle, and Burkett has the first down. Working on the safety, Brian Peters. Martinez to Burkett.
Yeah, good play call by Tim Beck. Knowing Northwestern coming with the fire. One-on-one matchups. Good job by Martinez.
Two tight ends. Burkett caught behind the line of scrimmage. Northwestern, they've got some penetration throughout the game. Vince Brown on that tackle for a loss.
Yeah, good leverage inside, getting up the field, winning one-on-one matchups. This is where Nebraska has struggled, in the red zone. Drive killers, important to get touchdowns when you get inside the 20.
Amir Abdullah comes in, number 8 for Nebraska. Martinez rolling right. Still on his feet, making something out of nothing, Martinez. Finally pushed out of bounds at the 15 by David Wabusi. Martinez took a hit on his way out of bounds by Wabusi.
Well, good coverage on the back end by Northwestern. Martinez just trying to get what he can get. Wabusi does a nice job ushering him out of bounds.
So it's third down and 8. Nebraska doesn't have a touchdown today. Caught! Touchdown, Tim Marlowe! Nebraska has finally scored a touchdown, first touchdown of the year for Jim Marlowe.
Just working the interior, Marlowe, great speed to run away from the defender.
And just like that, Nebraska has clawed back. They get an interception, they turn it into a touchdown the other way. Nebraska now down by just four. Nebraska feeling better about themselves. They've just scored their first touchdown. They trail Northwestern 14-10. We're still in quarter number three. Tim Marlowe, his first career touchdown catch, the junior from Youngstown, Ohio.
Yeah, he sort of reminds me of the old Iowa wide receiver Tim DeWhite. Very explosive. Get his team back in this thing.
Short kickoff. Jacob Schmidt on the return, and Schmidt gets out to the 22-yard line. Now it's time for Nissan Heisman history. On this date, 28 years ago, November 5th, 1983, Mike Rozier, all he did was rush for 212 yards and four touchdowns as the Huskers crushed Iowa State 72-29. Those four touchdowns in the game giving Rozier 24 in the season, breaking the previous Big Eight record of 23 by Oklahoma's Steve Owens, and breaking Johnny Rogers' career record for touchdowns of 45. Rozier at that point with 47. What a great player Mike Rozier was. Kane Colter still in at quarterback. Hands it off. Jacob Schmidt nowhere to go. Picks up a yard.
And Eric, if you're Northwestern, you have to diversify your offensive game plan when Trevor Siemian goes into the game, because all Nebraska's going to do is play the tendency. He's throwing the ball 100% of the time. What a luxury that is for that defense.
Colter, the quarterback in the game. And Colter, look at him scoop. He's got the first down. He's still on his feet. Colter out of bounds at the 45-yard line.
Colter is just so dynamic. You know, he can hurt you in so many ways, inside, outside. He has the physical toughness. Because you would think Nebraska is going to be able to get him down upon initial contact. Kind of like a pinball, he bounces off. That's Levante David. He doesn't miss too many tackles.
On first down, Colter to throw. Caught right at the sideline. Catch is made by Trayvon Green. Let's go down to Deion Miller. Deion.
Eric, I spoke with Northwestern head athletic trainer Tori Lindley, who told me that Dan Persa has soft tissue damage in his left shoulder, and his return remains questionable. It's just a matter of how much pain he can tolerate. You know he's in a lot of pain if he's on the sidelines. He's so tough. As for Jack Konopka, a left knee injury, his day is done, Eric.
Thank you. Yeah, new tight end of the game for Northwestern, John Placentia. Run on second down looks to be enough for another Northwestern full first down. Trayvon Green has got a lot of playing time today.
Northwestern's been mildly successful at running the ball right into the teeth of the Nebraska defense. This defense a little bit back on their heels right now.
Northwestern right now lining up without Drake Dunsmore or Jeremy Ebert on the field. They keep it on the ground. Trayvon Green with the rush. Levante David with the stop.
Green that time demonstrating some patience that you don't typically see from a freshman running back. Letting the hole develop.
So second down. Dunsmore comes back into the game, replacing Placencia. Ebert, though, still on the sideline. Green. Appears to be another Northwestern first down.
Well, I think some of the success Northwestern's having on the ground is a direct correlation with the way they play offense. The spread, it forces Nebraska into nickel and dime coverage. Get those big heavies up front blocking and going downhill, you can have some success. Northwestern's been able to gash Nebraska inside.
133 rushing yards for the Wildcats. First down, Coulter looking the wrong way. Tackled from behind by Austin Cassidy. Just a broken play. Coulter looked one way, Green was going the other.
Yeah. How about that picture for your quarterback? You're going to see Cassidy coming off the edge late. Closing in. Carl Pellini now dropping that safety down in the box to create a little more havoc against the Northwestern run.
Schmidt next to Coulter in the backfield. Schmidt has it. Probing close to the 30-yard line. It's going to bring up third down. Steinkuhler, another stop. Maybe the final play of our third quarter. Looks like Northwestern has no designs on calling one more play here in this third quarter.
Well, this is setting up for a very intriguing fourth quarter.
This would be Northwestern's biggest win of the year. They're going to go to the fourth quarter with a lead over the Nebraska Cornhuskers here in Lincoln, Nebraska. Can they hold on and get the big win they need? We'll find out the fourth quarter in a moment. Maybe not what everyone expected. Start of the fourth quarter. Northwestern on top of Nebraska 14-10. Not only does Northwestern have the lead, but they're going to have the wind at their back for the rest of the game. Third down situation. Third down and five. Kane Coulter hands it off. Schmidt, he's going to be stopped short of the first down marker by Damian Stafford. It's going to bring up fourth down and short.
An excellent communication that time by Levante David, All-American linebacker, Nebraska. He knew exactly where that run play was going. Good communication, good talk. That's the key to great defense.
So a field goal situation. This is not going to be routine. But Zine gets it up and misses wide left. The 45-yarder had enough light but didn't have the right angle. And it's going to be a sigh of relief for Nebraska.
And they just pushed it left. All the points are critical for Northwestern. That's three that they just left on the field.
Nebraska currently 10th in the BCS standings with just 10 points. On the Northwestern Wildcats, they trail 14-10. First possession here, the fourth quarter for Taylor Martinez and the Cornhuskers. Rex Burkhead once again is the eye back. Option left side. Burkhead going to be tackled for a major loss. Good tackle by the safety, Ibrahim Campbell. Let's go to Dave Revson in the studio for Discover Card Game Break.
Eric, thanks. The route is on in Madison. Monty Ball, his third touchdown of the game. 24 on the year. That ties Brian Calhoun's school records, 52-17 badge.
Thanks, Dave. Wisconsin playing with some anger this week after a couple of tough losses. Taylor Martinez makes the first man miss. He's going to keep it. Gets to the 30. It's going to bring up third down and long.
You're going to see how elusive Taylor Martinez is. This is a swing and a miss. Good job, good feel of understanding the rush. And then just going to be an athlete.
Here's a situation in which Nebraska has struggled so far today. Third down and long. It's third down at 7 right now. Three receivers all, top of your screen, left side of Taylor Martinez. Gets out of the pocket. Pass is knocked up in the air. It is incomplete. Tyler Scott looked like he had a chance to pick it off. Couldn't wrap it up. But it's going to be a three and out. Looks like Nebraska's going to have to punt the football.
Yeah, another nice stand by the Northwestern defense. You're going to see Martinez. He doesn't have anything there. Good coverage down the field, so it gets flushed out. Nice job of working. He actually throws it off of his teammate's helmet.
That hit his center, Mike Caputo, right in the helmet. There is a Northwestern player down. Northwestern has had their share of injuries already today. Dan Persa, one of the tight ends. Jack Konopka already out of today's game. We'll take a timeout. Come back to Lincoln in a moment. Veteran defensive end Vince Brown being helped off the field. Hopefully nothing too serious, but looks like he's in pain right now. Brown and the Northwestern defense stopping Nebraska. Three and out. And so Nebraska going to punt the football away. Benrick Mark back deep to receive this print punt to Brett Maher. Low kick. It's going to go over the head. Land inside the 20 and take a right-hand turn. So, nice kick, no return. And Northwestern will have some work to do when they take over with that four-point lead. Northwestern on offense on top 14-10 when we come back.
Welcome back to Memorial Stadium, where the Wildcats have a 14-10 lead on the Huskers in the fourth quarter. A busy day for the Northwestern training staff. In the first half, senior safety Brian Peters broke his left hand. It is heavily casted, but playing very tough. Still trying to contribute for his team, and they are still tending to injured defensive end Vince Brown, Eric.
Thank you, Dion. Northwestern's offense on the field. Keeper Kane Coulter tackled at the 20-yard line. This is a pivotal possession for Northwestern, Chris.
Yeah, it certainly is. And I want to go back for a second to Dion's report about Peters. It's going to be critical for him because not so much in the pass game in terms of getting in interceptions, but using those hands to get Burkhead on the ground late into this ball game.
Coulter wants to throw. Ebert has it. Look at Ebert. Does he have the speed? He's got a chance. He's going to score. Yards, Coulter to Ebert, and Northwestern surging once again.
And once again attacking the middle of the Nebraska defense. We've talked about how vacated it is because of the shell and the look that they give. That time Ebert using his 4-4 speed to blow past the defensive back of Nebraska.
Man down for Nebraska, Terrence Moore being tended to at the 22-yard line while Northwestern is celebrating on the other side of the field.
Well, when you have a receiver that can get deep quick, that's what Ebert does. He stacks the defender. Ciante Evans gets him in trail position. Pitch and catch. Six more points for the Wildcats.
Chris, even though Northwestern had been up by four, it seemed like they were hanging on for dear life until that long touchdown, Coulter to Ebert.
Yeah, and it's just a confidence builder for that offense who've been able to get some big pops today. You know, we talked about Northwestern not necessarily throwing it vertically, but if you can take a short route and make a deep play, it has a strong effect as well. Coach Fitzgerald has to be pleased with the play selection and also the individual wins that he's been getting from his team.
Oh, man.
You look at the other side of this thing. Coach Pelini knows that you can't give up big rips. It's the big plays that get you killed. Disciplined football, everything that he's about, at times have been missing for the Huskers today.
Yeah, we talked to Bo Pelini and his staff, and he said, you know what? We keep our safeties deep. We prefer the teams earn their way down the field, nickel and dime. We're not going to give up the big play. Well, Chris, they gave up the big play right there.
They most certainly did, and rarely do they do that. It's the design of the coverage is not to give up the big pops. But Ebert did a nice job of exploiting the center of the field and running past the coverage.
Ebert now with 8 touchdowns on the season. He has got 18 touchdowns in his career. At his third all-time at Northwestern, the great Dwayne Bates, 26 receiving touchdowns in his career.
This has been a wild one. Northwestern, we knew it was important for them to have a fast start, and they did just that. I thought they were able to build up some confidence going up against one of the best defenses in the Big Ten, but they've had variety. Team Coulter makes some plays, Person making them early, but Nebraska's been able to battle back. Marlowe finding the house. But this is a Northwestern team that has been unfazed by this defense and continuing to make big play after big play.
That is our Sprint Unlimited update. Terrence Moore has been helped to the sideline. And now here's Jeff Budzien to try the extra point. So it's a 21-10 Northwestern lead. Still 12 minutes, 16 seconds left to play. Big Ten Network Football is brought to you by State Farm. For auto, home, life, and banking, get to a better state. And by Verizon, America's largest and most reliable wireless network. Beautiful look at the Love Library here on campus. Nebraska's got some work to do. Nebraska, they control their own destiny in the Legends Division, but not if they lose today. A home game against Northwestern, they are in trouble right now. Bo Pelini's team down by 11 with 12 minutes and 16 seconds left to play. Bell and Abdullah back deep for the Huskers. It's going to be Kenny Bell. He starts from the one. Trying to get a full head of steam, dives out across the 25-yard line. Now, can't say enough about how Northwestern is playing. This is a Northwestern team that this year surviving a five-game losing streak, but right now they are really playing with confidence.
Well, and you've seen a little bit of a personality shift. If you look at this Nebraska defense, they don't typically give up the big pops. Northwestern, they get Evert involved, get him down the field. Now, all of a sudden, they're taking the fight to Nebraska.
If I'm Nebraska, should I be worried that they don't have enough offense to score the 11 points they need to tie it in the final 12 minutes?
Exactly, because now you're putting the ball in the air consistently, which is not your strength.
Quincy Anunua had a crucial fumble in the first half. Hangs on to that one. Good first down play for the Huskers. Pickup of 9.
That was one of the things that Pat Fitzgerald, coach at Northwestern, said to us this week, is they have to take the fight to Nebraska. Northwestern has done just that.
Martinez flips it out. This is Marlowe. Marlowe a touchdown earlier in the second half. Struggles out across the 40. That'll be another first down for Nebraska. There is a flag down late. While we have a moment, let's take a look at our Verizon key connection. It's Martinez and his eye back Burkhead.
Yeah, you talk about Burkhead. He's not just a throwback runner. He can catch the ball out the backfield, do some damage in the air as well.
Personal foul, clipping. Offense number 77, 15-yard penalty. Repeat second down.
Oh, that'll just rip your guts out. Jung-hoon Choi called for that penalty, and that is a big one. So move the football all the way back to the 26-yard line. Choi is one of the linemen that rotates in. A junior from right here in Lincoln. Fifth-year senior with the defense.
Outstanding defense by Maben. That time Maben just played the sticks. Played it aggressively against Anunua. See how he gets the left arm. That's well timed. Good defense, expecting, anticipating the route, and really running it better than Anunua.
Now his 46th career start for Maben. He has been through a lot of Big Ten games. Third down and 10. Line to get is the 36. Martinez. Complete. It's Marlowe. And he's got the first down. Boy, did the Huskers need that.
Well, they did, and at a critical moment. But let's not forget that this team came back against Ohio State. They have the capabilities of putting the ball in the air consistently, and they have great conviction about what they do. So this is still a big test for this Cats team to get off the field.
Another passing situation, complete. This is Bell, another first down for Nebraska. These passes are dangerous, but they're just getting through.
Effective, and Bell that time, young receiver, playing like a wily veteran. Watch how he uses his body positioning to shield out the defensive back. That's outstanding.
Martinez wants to throw again. Nobody open, takes it himself. Team magic inside the 40 to the 39. Tyler Scott finally stops him.
Plays that you can make with your feet when nothing's there. Talking about this team, very aggressive in the second half, very resilient, showing the ability to come back. Starts with this drive.
Playbook wide open here. Second down and three. How aggressive will Nebraska be? Incomplete, should have been caught. Kinney, he's had a good day. Juggled it and dropped it.
Well, I mentioned that comeback against Ohio State. You know it starts with number three, T-Magic. Willing his team back in it. And none were making a big play. Burkhead doing what he always does.
Third down. This time, Kinney with the catch. Looks like he's got enough for the first down. That was a fastball. Martinez really dialing it out there to Brandon Kinney.
Just good rhythm and harmony with Kinney, who pushes just past the stick, sits down, catches it in front of Maben.
He's been the main target for Martinez. Kinney now has six catches on the afternoon. Looking deep, Kinney, and a flag down on the field. Jordan Maben trying to stay up with Brandon Kinney.
And how about that play selection by Tim Beck? Just a setup move. You run quick hitch at Maben, quick hitch at Maben, and then you run a hitch and go. Timely play call.
Pass interference, defense number 26. 15-yard penalty, automatic first down.
A lot of hand play toward the end of that route. If Maben gets his head around and plays the ball, the official would slide off of that call. When they can clearly see he was defending the man, that's the reason they pulled the flag.
So the ball placed at the 20-yard line. Quarterback run, Martinez, still on his feet. Oh, down to the 6-yard line, refusing to be stopped.
When you're the field general, like Martinez is, you call your own number. When things get a little scary, call your own number. That's exactly what he does. Northwestern, we talked about Peters, his hand, couldn't get him on the ground.
Play action, Martinez just had to get it away. He was under some serious duress. Damian Proby, and now a late flag is dropped in the vicinity of Taylor Martinez. This is a very late flag thrown in.
Potential grounding, offense number three. Quarterback is out of the pocket, and the ball did not cross the line of scrimmage. Loss of down at the spot of the foul. Second down.
You're going to see it here. Martinez rolling out. Good pressure. Official said the ball did not cross the line of scrimmage.
So that's a big hit. That's going to drop him back to the 16-yard line. There is no potential of a first down. They need to get to the end zone. Second down, they've got some downs to work with, but they need something here. Martinez with time. Tries the right side. Flips it out. It is caught. Keeps the play alive and finds Ben Cotton for six.
Yeah, Cotton makes the catch. Martinez makes the play. Great throw. Look at the extension. Look where the knee is down.
Ooh, man, low.
take a look at
that. On the field is a catch. The runner reached out and touched the pylon for a touchdown. The previous play is under further review.
Watch where the knees go down.
Chris, the guy trying to make the tackle is Brian Peters, who's playing basically one-handed. He's got that club on his left hand, as you can see right there on your screen.
Yeah, which intensifies when you go against a physical Nebraska team. You can't grab cloth. It's hard to hold on and wrap up.
Is there a knee down? Is there a hand down?
I think you got both down.
Is there that indisputable video evidence to overturn the call on the field, which was touchdown?
Well, you said it right. Close call.
He's down.
Yeah. Look at that right knee down on the ground. I think this comes off the board.
John Corris, today's replay official, conversing with Dave Whitvoet.
That was a major league throw by Martinez. On the move, puts it right there. Beautiful throw.
If and when Nebraska scores a touchdown, you'd imagine they're going to go for two.
After further review, the runner's knee was down when the ball was at the 1 yard line. It would be third down at the 1 yard line.
Yep, they got it right. So it's still a big gainer, but the ball is going to be spotted short of the goal line. It'll be third down and one. Third down and goal from the one.
Nebraska put a big fullback in there. Look at Burkhead. Body on body, let the road graders do the work up front.
Now they're going to go without a fullback. The eye back is Burkhead behind Martinez. They give it to him. Looking for a hole. Does he find it? He does. Touchdown, Nebraska. Really what this did is it gives the Cornhuskers more time to think of a two-point play they want to run here.
Sure. You know, it's something they practice all week. We'll see how deeply they go into the playbook.
As it is, Nebraska down five. They want to get down within three and a field goal. Still a ton of time. Just under 9 minutes to play here in this fourth quarter. They bring in Aaron Green, true freshman from San Antonio. He's number two. He's the eye back behind Burkhead, who will now flip out left side of your screen. Option. Martinez. Did he get there? Yes! Two more points for Nebraska.
And actually defended fairly well by Northwestern. But just a better play and athlete by Martinez. So there's the pitch man. Comes up, that's Campbell. Oh. It's a great looking shot.
And we're looking at the knees. Didn't appear as if either of the knees hit the ground before the ball crossed the goal line.
Effort, desire. The key by Martinez, knowing that he needed to make the play and get it in there. Swinging that momentum to Nebraska.
So Nebraska, desperately in search of win number eight on the year, hoping to go 4-1 in Big Ten play. But they're still down by three. Their defense is going to need to make a stop.
See, there's a pitch man, Campbell. He's got him dead to rights. But Martinez slides inside and able to get full extension.
In college football, every play is reviewed, some longer than others. Obviously, the replay official looking at that and signing off and saying two more points for Nebraska. So it is a three-point game. Cornhuskers will kick it off from the 30. into the wind. Short kick. The dangerous Fenric Mark. Here he comes. And Mark tackled at the 34-yard line. Open field tackle made by Dejon Washington.
Northwestern going to have optimal field position, though. Short kick. Now this is an offense. Settle in. Continue to stay within the framework of what's been working all day. Nebraska needs to have a big stand.
Kane Coulter remaining in the game at quarterback. In case you're just joining us, Dan Persa has not played a snap here in the second half.
Look at the communication by the defense, making the adjustments.
Schmidt, huge hole out close to the 50. Just a gaping hole. Austin Cassidy and Alfonso Dennard finally with the tackle. But a good gain of 14 for Schmidt.
And Levante David mad himself. Watch him shoot the gap. Had him right there. Missed him. Allowed Schmidt to leak out yardage.
Not the game that probably most Cornhusker fans expected. Another handoff, Schmidt. And Schmidt again, large chunks of real estate. Farrell makes the stop, but a pickup of 11. When Big Ten football Saturday is over, the final drive presented by Sprint breaks it all down. In-depth highlights, analysis, and post-game reaction. The final drive presented by Sprint tonight, right after our game on BTN. Northwestern playing with the wind at their back. It is a significant win. A couple of good runs by Jacob Schmidt. And the Wildcats keep it on the ground. Coulter keeps it. A lot of room. Coulter slides at the 27-yard line.
Yeah, and he's hitting himself, saying he tried to stay in bounds. He does a nice job, though. He fakes the quick screen, pulls it in, wisely gets down, saved from the contact.
Clock stops temporarily with the first down, and now the clock moving once again. Under 7.5 minutes to play. Dan Persa can only watch. He hurt his shoulder in the first half of play. Now Jacob Schmidt replaced as the running back, Trayvon Green. In next to Coulter, and this is Green, a true freshman, pushing forward. Finally stopped at about the 23-yard line.
I think one of the keys for Northwestern today is their ability to get production in the run game from guys other than Coulter and Persa. We've seen some big rips by Jacob Schmidt. Trayvon Green's had some success on the ground. That's been a key storyline today. And Nebraska's defense up front, they got to take a stand, dig their heels in, and play with more leverage.
186 rushing yards for the Wildcats. Hand off again. Green looking for something. Gets inside the 20, down to the 18. It's going to bring up a third down and short. What's the play call here, Chris?
Well, they've been having success on the ground. No need to put it in the air. Keep it in Kane Coulter's hands. Third and manageable. That's been the key for Northwestern. Just keep this ball on the ground.
If you're wondering, both sides with three timeouts at their disposal, you can find it upper left-hand part of your screen, just underneath both teams' scores. Third down and one. Coulter keeps it. Cameron Meredith met him.
The right play call, though. Just better defense by Nebraska.
He didn't get anywhere close.
No, but you want the ball in his hands. Just good penetration. Meredith beats a one-on-one block.
So, Chris, it's fourth down and one, and it appears as if Northwestern's going to go for it instead of going for a field goal.
taking the points if I'm Northwestern. Under 6 minutes in the game.
Now the play clock winding down. Northwestern's going to call a timeout and think about it. Yeah, Pat Fitzgerald's done this before.
Northwestern.
He calls a timeout. Decision time for the brain trust of Northwestern. We'll be back to Lincoln in a moment. Welcome back, everyone. 5:05 left to play in this one. Northwestern up three. They're going to go for it on fourth down and one. Kane Coulter, the quarterback. He's got Jacob Schmidt next to him.
Look at the defense making adjustments. Levante David shifting their guys. Feel like they've seen this play.
Coulter gonna keep it. He's got the first down. Wow, Pat Fitzgerald with the guts of a cat burglar.
And if you're gonna make that call, you give it to one of your top guys. Coulter keeps the ball in his hands. Just an option. He knows that he's got the lane and the yardage. He takes a shot at the end. Nonetheless, he moves the chains.
So Northwestern missed a field goal earlier in this fourth quarter. They decide not to attempt one there, and they go for it, and they're rewarded. Coulter keeps it. Inside the 10, Cassidy with another tackle, and a flag comes in late. We've got some jawing down at about the 5-yard line.
This has been a physical contest, a lot of banging inside. Guys getting injured, going down. Chippy, a lot of trash talking. Emotional game for both sides.
There are two fouls on the play, personal foul on the defense, personal foul on the offense, goes offside.
I think it was on Levante David of Nebraska and Kristen Jones of Northwestern. Oh no, they're gonna call it Cameron Meredith, 34, a little bit of a swinging of the arm. And after the play, that's Kristen Jones, number 14, true freshman who got into it. Second down and 5. Green. At about the 5-yard line, it'll bring up third down.
But again, look at it, Eric. It's third and short. Northwestern has done this all day long. Good on first and second down, which leads to third and manageable. Very manageable.
I don't know if Nebraska can afford to give up another touchdown. A field goal, they still got a puncher's chance. But a touchdown could end it. Third and one. Coulter keeps it. First down, Northwestern. And that's going to take more time off the clock. Maybe Nebraska thinking about burning timeouts now.
This Nebraska defense has been just victimized today between the tackles. Northwestern, good blocking up front. And you think he likes it? Again, a series of one-on-one battles and matchups. Offensive line that's controlled the line of scrimmage and the point of attack and really enabled the backs to go off today for Northwestern.
Well, already today, both teams have turned the ball over in the red zone. Gotta be careful. First and goal. Schmidt. Down to the one. Damian Stafford stopped the touchdown. Took a helmet to the chest to bring him down.
Oh, but they're burning that clock. You're gonna see again right in the teeth of the defense. Stafford doing a nice job of bringing his feet, running through the contact.
Clock continues to move. Nebraska has all three timeouts. Now Northwestern breaks the huddle. There's 7 seconds on the play clock. Coulter, a keeper. No signal. He didn't get in. Clock continuing to move.
That was nice anticipation by the Nebraska defense. understanding that Coulter was going to run a sneak, they really loaded up inside to race the run lane. Watch how they squeeze down. Stack inside. Do a good job of just creating a pile.
You know, and I'm surprised that Nebraska's not calling any timeouts. I know they need to stop defensively, but they've got three timeouts, and the clock is just moving. When they get the ball back, they're not going to have a whole lot of wiggle room. And now a timeout is called.
Timeout, Nebraska. It's their second.
Yeah, a little late to pull the trigger there.
So 1:43 left to play. Pat Fitzgerald and Northwestern looking for the decisive touchdown. We'll be back in a moment. Welcome back, everyone, after the Northwestern timeout. Here we go. Coulter going to keep it. Did he get in? No signal. Touchdown, Northwestern.
And we may have just seen a knockout punch.
Who would have thought when push came to shove that Northwestern would out physical Nebraska?
Well, and I think that play is indicative of what you saw today. Good punch up front, penetration, that's an easy call.
And this is going to be waved off. Replay official just going to get an opportunity to look a little longer.
Was a touchdown. Previous play is under further review.
I'm not sure if there's going to be any shot that's going to be clear. Ruling on the field is a touchdown.
Going into this game, one of the concerns, naturally, when you have a spread team, which is a little more finesse, could they match the physicality in the pure strength of Nebraska? I think Northwestern has answered those questions well today. Good push up front and really control the line of scrimmage.
Ruling on the field is a touchdown. You need indisputable video evidence to overturn a call on the field. Unless the replay official is seeing something that I haven't. Just looked like a big blob to me.
Further review of the ruling on the field stands.
And the key word stands, that means there's no video evidence to overturn the call. It's not confirmed, it's just it stands because of what was called on the field. So the extra point now with 1:34 left to play, and Northwestern already up by 9. This makes it a 10-point lead.
And there's a lot of fans heading toward the exit here in Lincoln.
We'll be back. 1:34 left to play here in Lincoln. Northwestern fans hoping to paint the town purple tonight. They have come to Lincoln, Nebraska. And the Wildcats, a surprising 10-point lead with 1:34 left to play. One positive for Nebraska, or it's kind of a stretch. They do have all three of their timeouts. The ball spins off the tee because of the wind. Take a look at today's Polaris hardest working player. It's Taylor Martinez of Nebraska.
He's grinding it out here and really throwing the ball a little better than I anticipated. Of course, they used him in the run game. But in the critical moments, Northwestern's defense stepped up and made the plays.
This is not Martinez's strength, the 2-minute drill. Cotton can't hang on.
Lack of focus that time by Cotton. Ball hits him right in the hands. He puts it on the ground.
Nebraska, three consecutive wins after a loss at Wisconsin. 3-1 in the Legends division. In danger of losing for the second time. Bell with the catch, gets out of bounds. That stops the clock. Already today, Michigan a loser in the Legends division. Should Nebraska lose, it would mean that Michigan State, the lone unbeaten team, left in the Legends division. Wide open, catch is made. Kyler Reed crosses the 50, clock stops temporarily as he gets to the 41. Nebraska still with all three timeouts.
Yep, minute and 10 left in this one. Northwestern being, of course, very conservative on defense.
Martinez's arm was hit. And it's going to bring up second down. Our U.S. United States Marine Corps leader of the game is going to be Kane Coulter, the sophomore from Colorado, playing the bulk of the second half with Dan Persa out with the injury and putting up numbers and scoring the decisive touchdown, what appeared to be the decisive touchdown a moment ago. Martinez throws long. Bell tripped up a bit, no flag. Matthews on the coverage. It's going to bring up third down.
Yeah, incidental contact that time with Matthews.
Well, Nebraska needs two scores. It almost makes sense just to get either the field goal or the touchdown whenever they can. If they can just get another 20 yards, there's no reason to go to the end zone. All they need is a field goal, onside kick, get the ball back. Maybe easier said than done. Caught by Marlowe. Short of the first down marker. It's going to bring up fourth down, and Nebraska burns its first timeout.
Timeout. Nebraska, their first.
And should Northwestern go on to win this one, they've certainly earned it. Coming out, taking the fight to the Huskers. But I also thought that Nebraska had some self-inflicting wounds. We talked about the turnovers giving more life to Northwestern and creating greater opportunities. It certainly doesn't get any easier for Nebraska as we take a look at their upcoming schedule.
Yeah, welcome to the Big Ten. At Penn State, at Michigan, and against Iowa. For Northwestern, well, they're just trying to get to six wins and become bowl eligible after having that five-game losing streak middle of the season. They go non-conference next week against Rice, and then they've got Minnesota at home and Michigan State at home. A win today totally changes their perspective in terms of postseason.
And their confidence level. You have to assume they win this today, that they feel like they can beat any team on their schedule.
Fourth down and two. Nebraska stays alive. Short gainer to the tight end, Reed. That'll stop the clock temporarily at 43 seconds. Choosing not to use a timeout, only lose a couple of seconds. They're going to go to the end zone. Kitty was covered perfectly by Jordan Maben.
Nebraska really played against two teams today. They played against Northwestern and themselves, creating a lot of opportunities that the Cats exploited offensively and defensively.
And from right here, it would be about a 42-yard field goal into the wind. So Nebraska can continue to look for a touchdown. Pass is complete. Burkhead. Burkett still on his feet, trying to get to the edge, gets a great block, and he gets out of bounds at the 15-yard line.
Wow.
Man still down for Northwestern. Quincy Anunua with the block.
One thing about these receivers for Nebraska, they're extremely physical. So when you're in the center of that field, you got to keep your head on a swivel.
It's Jerevin Matthews down on the field. Well, Chris, while we have this stoppage, maybe Nebraska's going to think about kicking a field goal here. You need a touchdown and you need a field goal. You're down by 10 points. Doesn't make a difference which order you get them in, but you need to save as much time on the clock as possible. Do you think Bo Pelini would consider going for a field goal here, going for the onside kick, and then getting the touchdown?
I think he'd be a little more conventional. Try and go in and get the touchdown. Had some success. Burkhead just makes a big play. You got the momentum. Go ahead and try and get in the end zone. Right side of the screen. There's Matthews. That's a crushing block by Nunwa. Oftentimes, receivers working a back outside, inside. Defensive backs don't really know that they're there. I thought Matthews played pretty well today.
We will take a timeout. We'll come back to Lincoln in a moment. Jervin Matthews being looked at just a moment ago. Sitting up, now hoping to stand up. He just didn't see a hit coming. Quincy Anunua blocking him when Matthews was looking in the other direction.
Nice gesture by the fans here in Lincoln. Applauding him. Good to see him get on his feet, Matthews. It's like sort of a crackback block. Your body becomes extremely vulnerable.
So with Matthews going to the sideline, number 15, Daniel Jones checks in. First down and 10. Martinez. Touchdown, Nebraska. Kenny Bell.
And I thought, kind of to your point earlier, that was just a beautiful call by Coach Pelini to go for it. Your offense is in rhythm. You're getting chunks of yardage. Nice to cap it off with a touchdown. Bell doing a good job finding the hole in the defense. We're getting it in the end zone.
Now this extra point, crucial. It was tipped at the line, but it still goes through. And Nebraska down by 3 with 18 seconds left. They're going to need a successful onside kick.
Yeah, and you know they practice for it all week. Part of the preparation. Northwestern, of course, will counter with their hands team. Get on the football.
Northwestern a win a week ago against Indiana, trying to make it two wins in as many weeks. This after losing 5 in a row. Win today, and they would move to 4-5 on the year, 2-4 in the leader in the Legends division. But still some work to do. They need the football. Keep it away from Nebraska.
I don't think you can put a price tag on what this would do for the confidence level of Northwestern Wildcats as they go through the balance of their schedule. But they need to recover it here.
Ball needs to go 10 yards, so it's going to have to go to at least the 40-yard line before Nebraska can try and recover it.
If you're the kicker, you just got to give your guys a chance.
Wow, and Nebraska, no, they pointed. Referee pointed to Nebraska. If Nebraska called that timeout, they're down to their last one. And that is a crucial error should they get the ball back.
Well, I think Coach Pelini, someone had to be misaligned for Nebraska to burn a timeout in that situation. But I guess if you don't give yourself a chance to recover, you're dead to rights anyhow.
So here it is, folks. Ball needs to go to at least the 40-yard line. And it falls off the tee on this windy afternoon.
Interesting thing is you can't take a guy off to come hold it. So essential to recovering this.
Ball is loose. And Northwestern has the football. Fifth-year senior from Chicago, Charles Brown. Just jumps on the football, and Northwestern, only a mistake can keep them from winning this game.
And that's well played by Brown. So they make it look like they're going to go the opposite way. Being the shortstop, watch him bend the knees, go down, fall on it, and put a bow on this win for Northwestern.
Coulter with the kneel down. Nebraska has a timeout. They choose not to use it. And Northwestern comes to Lincoln and wins for the first time.
And this team of Nebraska and this crowd just stunned. As is Coach Pelini. Now Coach Pelini respected Northwestern. And you didn't feel like it was empty rhetoric. He thought that this Northwestern team was tough. They demonstrated that today.
All is not lost for Taylor Martinez and Nebraska, but they've got some work to do. They now have two losses on the year, and they slip in the Legends division, not what they were hoping to do against a team in Northwestern that has really struggled at times this year. All right, Deion Miller standing by with Northwestern's happy head coach.
Obviously celebrating. Coach, you come in here, you grab the early lead, you're able to hang on. What was the difference today?
Well, you know, I thought from a standpoint of the way our defense played and the way Kane really stepped up when we lost Danny there, a little injury. Really proud of our guys, extremely proud of our seniors and our coaching staff. And, you know, we got a lot of work still left to do, but it's great to come in here and get a win. Very proud of our guys.
You mentioned Kane. How did you see him managing this game, especially down the stretch?
Well, I didn't see him manage. I saw a guy go out to make plays to win, you know, and that's what's so fun about college football. You go play to win.
What does a win like this do for you guys? You want this to be, as you said, a November to remember.
Well, it's our second step. Now we get to go home. We've been on the road six times, and it's been a long haul, but, you know, now we got to go home, and all this will be for naught unless we win humbly and go back to prepare the way we have the last 2 weeks. And again, I'm proud of our staff, proud of our guys, and it's going to be a nice flight home. We needed this one big time.
That's certainly a big one today, Coach. Thanks so much, Eric.
Thank you, Deion. With that win, Pat Fitzgerald moves past his mentor, Randy Walker, for second place all-time in Northwestern's all-time coaching list. We'll be back here in Lincoln to wrap things up in a moment. Northwestern, a winner, 28-25.